How does one hear a sound? It's actually a complicated process involving many steps which all need to work together smoothly, otherwise hearing loss occurs. In order to understand hearing loss, one needs to first understand how normal hearing works. Normally, sound travels through the ear canal which then vibrates the eardrum. The eardrum in turn vibrates the malleus, then the incus, followed by the stapes. The stapes then stimulates the cochlea through a small opening called the oval window. Within the cochlea, small hair cells stimulate the hearing nerve which carries the signal to a specific location within the brain called Brodmann areas 41 and 42 of the temporal lobe. It is here where sound processing occurs, allowing an individual to actually perceive meaning among different sounds and understand speech. Hearing loss can be separated into three distinct categories. Conductive hearing loss due to problems on the blue side where sound transmission to the nerve is impeded. Conductive hearing loss is correctable. Nerve hearing loss on the red side where the sound signal to the brain is diminished. Typically, nerve hearing loss is irreversible and most require hearing aids in order to hear better. Finally, there is central auditory processing disorders which affects the brain's ability to process and understand the sounds it hears. Let's go through each of these hearing loss types in more detail. Anything that blocks an open ear canal can cause hearing loss. Such conditions include earwax, fluid, infection, foreign body, and abnormal growths. Anything that impedes the eardrum's ability to vibrate can adversely affect hearing. Examples include a large hole, scarring, thickening, or abnormal growth. The middle ear space should normally be filled with air without any pressure. However, if there is negative or positive pressure, any fluid, infection, or a mass, it will prevent the eardrum and middle ear bones from moving as well as it should, resulting in hearing loss. The middle ear bones themselves should move freely. However, these bones can break, dislocate, or fixate, also leading to hearing loss. Various cochlear conditions can cause nerve hearing loss, including hair cell damage and endolymphatic high drops. The hearing nerve itself can be damaged due to nerve infection or inflammation. A mass can also pinch the nerve, causing it to become dysfunctional. Finally, a variety of brain conditions can lead to a perceptual hearing loss as well, even if the ear itself can hear perfectly normal. These conditions are all roughly grouped into a category known as central auditory processing disorders. As such, hearing loss can be complicated, simple, reversible, permanent, or perceptual. An ENT specialist can help distinguish between all these different possibilities and recommend appropriate corrective interventions.